Hello Midcarders, this is Looney and today I'm going to give you 10 reasons why Seth Rollins is the guy of WWE. Number 10. He's a workhorse. If you have seen the evolution of Seth Rollins over the years, then you know what I'm talking about. His quality of matches have improved amazingly since he split from The Shield. He has had awesome matches with opponents like Finn Balor, Roman Reigns, John Cena, The Miz and Kevin Owens. Number 9. He's a Grand Slam champion. I know, being a Grand Slam champion doesn't make you the guy in WWE. Take a look at Dolph Ziggler, Randy Orton, Jeff Hardy, The Miz and Roman Reigns. Yes, Roman is not the guy in WWE anymore, bite me. But being a Grand Slam guy is an advantage and can be pretty helpful in establishing Seth as the guy if the booking is done right, which is exactly what's happening to Rollins right now, you lucky dog. Number 8. He connects with the crowd. To be the guy, the top babyface, a wrestler needs to establish a relationship with the crowd, and Seth is doing it with perfection. His redemption storyline and getting back on the top to be Monday Night Rollins once again is all we need to get behind him. Number 7. His rise, fall and rise storyline. Storytelling is at its best when it comes to Seth. He once won the WWE Championship at WrestleMania, but he had to relinquish the title due to an injury. Then he made his return and won the WWE Championship at Money in the Bank 2016, which was then won by Dean Ambrose with a cash-in. He then got injured again at the hands of Samoa Joe. The back-to-back injuries led to his downfall in the card as a babyface. But then his redemption storyline with Dean Ambrose becoming tag team champions with him and then Jason Jordan. With his current IC title reign, he is definitely on the rise to be the top guy once again. Number 6. He was never shoved down our throats. Oh, poor Roman Reigns. Just look at Rusev, Elias and Braun Strowman. They all got over with the crowd by just being themselves. Except for Strowman. He actually got over because he used to beat the crap out of Roman Reigns. But you get my point here. Rollins grew on the fans organically. That's why he's legit the most cheered wrestler on Raw. Or maybe the entire WWE. Number 5. He knows how to cut a promo. Just go watch his promos when he was a heel champion. People hated him and loved him at the same time for his awesome bad guy portrayal. He's cool and charismatic on the mic. Now as a babyface, people buy into what he says. He sounds like a legit badass because when he says that he's going to stomp someone's head into the floor, he does. Speaking of stomp, number 4. He has an awesome finisher. Most of the WWE matches ends with a cool finishing move. However, many top WWE superstars have a finisher that doesn't look that deadly, like Cena's AA, the Rock Bottom, or even the F5. Yes, I just said that. But some finishers just hit the right spot. They look deadly and the crowd pops with it. The same is with the Curb Stomp. Seth's finisher struggled with the WWE management, but finally we saw it once again several months ago against Finn Balor. It looks cool like a stone cold stunner and one can imagine that it's going to hurt. Just like the F5, the Curb Stomp has been protected ever since its return. Maybe, just maybe, WWE is on to something here. Number 3. He's a better wrestler than Roman. Fight me on this. I believe Seth and Roman have a great in-ring chemistry against each other. But when it comes to the match quality against lesser capable opponent, Seth can take out the best out of his opponents. Just look at the match between him and The Miz. Can you say the same about Roman versus The Miz for the IC title? The CrossFit Jesus was the Iron Man in the Raw Gauntlet match in February this year. Speaking of, number 2. He beat Roman Reigns and John Cena back to back. This was the wet dream of every hardcore wrestling fan. Two guys that are portrayed as almost impossible to defeat. They were promoted to a point where viewers have had enough. And now they were defeated one after another by a capable in-ring performer like Seth Freakin Rollins. This was the moment when he established himself as the top guy of WWE. And number one, he was once the biggest heel in WWE. Take a look back into the Attitude Era. Stone Cold, The Rock, Triple H, Shawn Michaels, The Undertaker were some of the biggest heels and then turned faces. Given the fact that the crowd legit hated them, they had the chance to organically grow on the WWE fans, something that Roman should have gotten, but instead it was Seth. He was the biggest heel of the WWE as the corporate champion, and now he's the biggest babyface as the people's IC champion. He's totally over with the crowd and people actually respect him. The IC title feels important in his hands, and I'm damn sure that the Universal title would feel like a big deal in his hands instead of Brock or Roman. Do you have more points you can add? Do leave a comment and let us know. If you like the content and the fan art, do give this video a thumbs up and share. Subscribe to the Midcard channel for more wrestling content like this.